Hey, Christy, would love to know how to upload a single audio source of two speakers and split them into two different layers so that I can easily export two different audio tracks, one per each speaker. Well, it is not possible automatically. Descript does not have this option. I see this question very, very often, but Descript does not offer this ability right now. What you can do is bring the same file in and you put it on two different tracks. You duplicate it effectively. Then, so in a sequence I'm talking, right? Here we go. So this is a Zoom recordings. And you know, Zoom recordings, they give you, unless you turn on the option to record separate speakers on separate tracks, it will give you a single file with both speakers, video and audio, right? So the important thing is that you identify the speakers, okay, on that file. If it's two speakers, three speakers, whatever, you need to right-click and say identify speakers if you haven't done it when you imported it, okay? That's important because the reason I like to do this is because it gives you these colors, right? So that's very important because if you're trying to do it manually, it's much easier to see the colors where all the speakers are talking, right? Where one stops and the other starts. However, what I'm going to say is this. Even if Descript had an option to do that automatically, I would not trust it because the speaker identification is pretty accurate, but it's not 100% accurate. So sometimes, and you may have seen this on Zoom, when you talk and you have the automated switching of the speaker, the person who speaks, it's about a second before the video switches because the AI needs a fraction of a second to actually identify who started talking in order to figure out which video to switch to. And I have this all the time. I have clients who send me Zoom recordings and they have this automated speaker switching. And Zoom's AI isn't much better than any other AI. So often I hear the person starts talking and then they show up like a second later, which means now I have a second of audio showing the wrong person. So this is really important because if this is the same thing that happens in Descript in here, if you're trying to do this automatically, Descript is going to switch the track late, okay? And I've seen it many times when maybe the speaker identification is just a little bit off, which means if it were done manually, you would actually cut off that person's speech right there. So in my opinion, it's actually easier and better to do this manually because you can see and hear what's going on. Let me show you how. After you identify the speakers, I have just this file in here. I'm going to right-click and say create sequence. Okay, so what I have in here is one sequence with one file. And if I scroll through, you see the colors for the different people, right? So what I would do is this. If I want to separate these two people on the tracks, what I go is this. I go to the add media and I choose the same file again and I add as a new track in here. Like that. There you go. So I've got two audios and two videos, of course, two audios, and they are different colors. So I decide, okay, the first one is Christy. That's mine. And the second one is Chris, my guest. Chris is in the red here and mine is purple. So I'm going to say, you know what? Without shifting these tracks forwards or backwards, I have to go in and delete the other person from the track they're not supposed to be on, okay? This is the simplest thing ever. So on the Christy track, I have to delete everything that's red, okay? So watch this. I will zoom in and I will go here. And the easiest way to do this is by using the range tool. You use the range tool and you select like that. You make a selection and you select as much as you can, click delete, and there it is, it's gone. Keep going. Oh, I've got a bit of red in here. Make sure that, look, this is an issue here. Descript hasn't identified who this little piece of the waveform belongs to, but you are a person. You know what you're doing, so you can play this and listen to it. So he's the one talking there, so I'm going to delete that too. So here we go. Select that and delete. The only important thing that you need to make sure you don't do in here is slide these tracks around, okay? You don't want to slide them around because you're going to lose your sync. You need to make sure they stay in sync. So here we go. Keep going. Oh, that's the red part. Delete that. It's gone. Keep scrolling. Here we go. That's another one. Delete that. So basically, this is something that Descript could actually do automatically to some degree, but you see all of those gray pieces of waveform, they are actually not identified correctly, or the words are misaligned or whatever. So now look at this. It's purple, but it's actually Chris talking. So it thinks I'm talking, but it's Chris talking here. The AI would probably have ignored that, but no, I want to delete it because it's part of Chris's speech, right? And you do this. I'm not gonna do this entire episode here, but now look at that. I have muted all of Chris's audio from my track. And what do I have to do next? You guessed it. I have to go to Chris's track and remove everything that's mine, which means I need to delete all of the purple stuff from this track in here. Look at that. So all the purple stuff. And you can actually use your initial work, the work you did on the other track, to inform your new cuts. So where you see purple in here, you actually have to remove purple for the same duration. And thankfully, Descript actually helps you with that because they have a little snapping in there. So watch this. If I move my mouse close to the beginning of the top clip, it will snap in place. So I just start dragging, delete, keep moving. You can zoom out if your cuts are, you know, you want to do longer cuts like that, delete that, keep going, and so on. And you can even expand these selections. Oops, I dragged it. I should not have dragged it. Go back. You can even select like that and delete. So this is the process I would do. And watch this. I've got now the audio separated on two tracks. And the final piece is this. When you finished all this, you want to export these tracks separately, like you said. Well, the first thing is you go to the first one and you click on it. So you use the select tool, click on the first track and go to the top and press this S here, solo track, like that. In this moment, only that track will play. Click done and then go to publish, go to export, go to audio, and export the current composition in whatever format you want, WAV, MP3, whatever it is. It's going to only export that track, which is soloed. You do that, you save that file, then you go back into the sequence again, and now you click on that, turn off the solo, click on the second one, solo that one too, the second track, click done, go publish, go export, audio, blah, blah, export again. And now you have the second person. And because you haven't shifted those tracks around, the duration is going to be the same. And each track is going to have the right person on it. That is my solution. It is manual, but it works.